Good wishes, dear students. In today's class, we will see or learn about another element of group number 13 that is placed below boron aluminium. Atomic number is also 13. These are a few ideas about the aluminium. It is one of the most abundant metal on Earth's crust. Occurs mostly as oxides. It's found in aluminosilicate rocks and in the bauxite ore. So commercial preparation of extraction, we derive it from the bauxite ore. The other elements in group number 13 are gallium, indium, thallium, and they occur as sulfides because compared to the occurrence of boron and aluminium, these are found only in small traces. So mostly they are in the form of a sulfide ores here. Now for your syllabus, you will be learning two compounds of aluminium. One is aluminium chloride, the other one is alums. Now as usual, when we move on to the preparation of aluminium, there are three preparations, out of which one is a very important one, the other two only for your knowledge purpose. Aluminium, when you treat with a hydrochloric acid, we get aluminium chloride and hydrogen is being released. Now, aluminium hydroxide, when you treat with the HCl, we get aluminium chloride and water is being released. So, all you have to remember here is, aluminium with the HCl releases hydrogen after the formation of aluminium chloride. Aluminium hydroxide with the HCl releases water after the formation of aluminium chloride. The next one, as you can see it in the picture, it's a very, very important preparation under aluminium chloride that's called as a McPhee process. It's nothing. Alumina, you treat with a carbon. When you heat these mixtures, as the temperature is increased, chlorine gas is being passed in it, and that's the meaning of current of chlorine is being passed. We get aluminium chloride and carbon monoxide. So McPhee process is nothing. Alumina, you treat with a carbon, and current of chlorine is being passed, nothing. When you heat the temperature, chlorine gas is being passed in it. We get aluminium chloride and carbon monoxide. Now, industrially, when we prepare, in large scale we need to prepare. So, industrial preparation, aluminium you treat with the chlorine. The temperature condition should be 1000 Kelvin. We get aluminium chloride. This method is also called as a chlorinating of aluminium. With this, we are finishing with the preparation of aluminium chloride. Out of it, McPhee process is a very important one. Moving on to the properties of aluminium chloride. 1 mark point of view, these properties are very important. Now, aluminium chloride exists in the two forms mainly. One is anhydrous aluminium chloride. The other one, aqueous solution of aluminium chloride. This word anhydrous you will come across in the Friedel-Crafts alkylation and acylation reaction. Right now, I'm not going to talk about it. What's the meaning of anhydrous? The molecule does not have the, or a chemical compound does not have the water molecule in it. It's anhydrous but hygroscopic substance. What's the contradiction between the thing? Anhydrous, when you say, it does not have the water molecule in it. But when you say hygroscopic, though it does not have on its own water molecule, it has the ability or capable of taking water molecule from the atmosphere and capable of retaining it too. So anhydrous aluminium chloride is hygroscopic substance. You understand the reason. I have written it clearly here. Coming back to aqueous solution of AlCl3, it's acidic in nature, meaning it releases proton. Now, it also produces hydrogen chloride fumes in a moist air. In 1 mark point of view, you need to remember these points. Now, moving back to, so aluminium chloride, you treat with water, aluminium hydroxide is being produced along with the HCl. Now, formation of aluminium hydroxide. So, AlCl3 you treat with ammonium hydroxide, we get aluminium hydroxide and ammonium chloride. Interchanging of ions takes place here. So aluminium combines with the hydroxyl ion, chlorine combines with ammonium ion. So aluminium hydroxide and ammonium chloride. The next one, formation of metal aluminate. So aluminium chloride, we treat with the excess of sodium hydroxide. So we get sodium meta-aluminate, the formula NaAlO2 with water and a formation of sodium chloride. NaCl get together as a sodium chloride takes place. So formation of meta-aluminate is nothing. Aluminium chloride you treat with excess of sodium hydroxide. Now one more note in terms of one mark point of view you need to remember. Now anhydrous aluminium chloride AlCl3 behaves as a Lewis acid. What's the meaning of Lewis acid? It accepts the lone pair of electron or a electron pairs. Thus accepting, it forms an addition compounds. For example, AlCl3 and 6 times the ammonia molecule. Similarly, it also combines with the phosphine, that's PH3, carbonyl chloride, etc. So anhydrous AlCl3 behaves as a Lewis acid. So when it behaves as a Lewis acid, it forms an addition compound. Few examples are given to you all. Thank you.